An Australian news presenter has taken offence to a 660 poster written in Te Reo Māori.
It happened during a discussion on free speech, of all things. Today, Kethiki Masalamani got the band's response.
A band not afraid of embracing its roots, 660 often incorporates Te Reo Māori in their waiata. But across the ditch, one broadcaster took offence.
Here's a poster for a pop group called 660. It's all in Māori. There's not a word of English anywhere in there.
In discussing the importance of free speech, the presenter was irked by the band's poster for their upcoming tour in New Zealand.
I said a large proportion of people in New Zealand don't actually speak Māori. How are they responding to this push to make this almost the national language?
Fact check, Te Reo Māori is already one of New Zealand's national languages. In its response, the band offered free tickets to Rowan Dean to see what it's all about. Despite saying he's reached out to the band, 660 says he hasn't, and he's yet to take them up on the ticket offer. Newshub tried to get a response from Dean, but didn't hear back.
Thought it was funny, we thought it was quite ironic that he was complaining about things like free speech and what we were doing when using Te Reo in our poster as an example of free speech.
660's use of Te Reo Māori is setting benchmarks.
It's going to be an exemplar, I think, for other bands and other musicians to follow so that we can normalise our language here in Aotearoa. It's all cool. It's cool to kōrero. Ko mana tō.
The three of us in the band are Māori, and it's been a way to kind of like tap into that journey for us, and I mean, it's been received really well.
And the band insists it adds a layer of magic to their performance.
It's an amazing feeling, you know, like we will probably do more. In fact, like after this, we'll probably do way more. Just for the hell of it.
Free to perform as they like, and free to embrace Indigenous cultures here and across the ditch. Kethiki Masalamani, Newshub.